Hi, I'm Gary Eckstein from organicweb.com.au. I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner, and this is the second episode where I answer your Mailchimp questions and answers. From the first episode, I received very positive feedback, lots of questions. So if you do have Mailchimp questions you'd like asked, please leave a comment on this video and subscribe to my channel to keep updated. The first question I'm going to answer today regarding Mailchimp is, what are bounced emails? So what are bounced emails? So let me go to a Mailchimp report, and that's probably where it's most commonly seen. So I'll click on campaigns, click reports, and I'll just go into one of my email reports. So I'm going to click view report, and I'll just wait for this to load up. I can scroll down the screen, I've got all my report, but we have bounced here. So if I click on bounced, we can see my bounced emails. So these are emails that I sent that weren't delivered. Let me be more precise about it. They were rejected by the receiving server for some reason. We get two types of bounces: hard bounce and soft bounce. A hard bounce is a permanent delivery problem. We send the email and the message is sent back by the receiving server saying, for example, the email address doesn't exist. So maybe we spelt it incorrectly, maybe the person's left their job. Okay, so that's a hard bounce. The other type of bounce is a soft bounce, and that's a temporary problem. Something like maybe the server's down temporarily, maybe the person's mailbox is full. That's the message that's received back by Mailchimp. With a hard bounce, with a hard bounce, the email address that it was sent to, that hard bounced, is immediately marked as cleaned in your audience. And I explained in the last episode what cleaned means. So they're marked as cleaned. We can't send to those people an email to that email address again. That's hard bounce. On a soft bounce, Mailchimp won't resend that same email to that person again. However, Mailchimp will allow you to send roughly the next five emails to that person. However, if all of those, you know, subsequent few emails soft bounce, Mailchimp will mark that person as cleaned in your audience. So that's hard bounce and soft bounce. So we can see on the screen at the moment that this email address was hard bounced. And I just know because I put it in like this. I didn't add the Y. So G-A-R-Y. I didn't add the Y. So this was hard bounced, permanent delivery problem. And if you do want to see why the email was rejected by the receiving server, you can scroll across and click bounce reason. So we click bounce reason, and among all this stuff, we can actually see the reason. And I just happen to know that it's down here. So the host, which was a Google, this email, it was sent to a Gmail server, said, the email account that you tried to reach does not exist. Please try double checking the recipient's email address for typos, unnecessary spaces. So that's what they've replied. So that's bounced. Soft bounce, hard bounce, total bounced, hard bounced, immediately marked as cleaned. Soft bounce, we can send the next few and then they're marked as cleaned. Marked as cleaned. And some people sort of say, okay, so if they are getting soft or hard bounces, maybe, you know, they should get on the phone to the recipient and say, hey, what's your new email address? Okay, let's go on to the second question. In Mailchimp, can I add another sending domain? Yeah, the answer is definitely yes, on a free account or paid account. If I click my name to the bottom left of the screen, and if I go to account, if I then go to settings, domains, we can see the domains overview, verify your email domain, and I can scroll down and the different things we can do with domains. So of course, Mailchimp isn't just about email marketing. We can create websites, landing pages, surveys, etc., etc. But here I'm showing how you can add another domain for your just for your email sending alone. So for example, if your company name changes, or maybe you have multiple brands in the same company and you want to use one Mailchimp account, You can see here I've added multiple domains. All we need to do to add a new domain that we can send from. So for example, in this account, I could send from Gary at 55tips.com, Gary at organicweb.com.au, etc., etc. I just click verify email domain, and you can just add the email address that works on the new domain. That email address will then get an email from Mailchimp saying, click here to verify that you have received the email, and then you'll be able to send from that domain. So just using a bad example, and I don't even know if Coca-Cola in Australia do, but I don't know if Coca-Cola worldwide use Mailchimp. But for example, they might want to, under one of their accounts, have Sprite, Fanta, Coca-Cola, Classic, you know, etc. Okay, so that's how we add another domain. So on to the next question, and then I have one more after that. What is the difference between segments and tags? Okay, this is a question I do get often. Let's go to our audience. So what is the difference between segments and tags in Mailchimp? I'll just view my contacts. There are various ways we can add data to Mailchimp. So let's just deal with data at the moment. We can add data into fields. Most accounts have 30 fields in Mailchimp. If you need more fields, you can go into a premium account, which will allow you 80 fields. So birthdays a field, membership numbers a field, last names a field, etc., etc. Okay, so 30 for most of us anyway. That's actually a lot of data, right? So we throw all our data into that. We can also add data into tags. And a tag is just, think of it like a label that we add. And you manually add them to people. Okay, there's ways we can automate them too, but just think that you'd manually add them. So let's say you had a bricks and mortar stores. You had one at your airport location and one at your CBD location. You might have one audience, and then you would tag people belonging to those, you know, CBD airport or CBD and airport and so on. So how most people in Mailchimp would manage a single audience, which is recommended for most organizations, you'd have a single audience, throw all your people, all your contacts into a single audience, and then you would tag them just as you would add new audiences in the past. One called, you know, CBD store, one called airport store, and you would just tag them. So we can have 30 columns, 30 fields of data for most of us. Tags is unlimited. We can have as many tags as we want. We can add tags, add as many as we want, with the limit, the only limit being that each individual tag can be a maximum of 100 characters long. So tags is just data. So the question was, what is the difference between segments and tags? Okay, so we've dealt with tags. It's just a label, or it's just data that we add. A segment, however, is how we target our marketing. So an important concept in marketing is that we send the most relevant message to the most relevant people. Now, if you know the concept of personas, buyer personas, where what we do is we sort of create maybe 3-5 personas who epitomize the average person that buys from us. Gender, maybe we include in that the geography, maybe we include average spend, what their hobbies are, etc. Okay, and then we target our marketing at those people. So because the message might be very different for a certain commonality of people versus another commonality of our buyers. So we target our marketing, very important concept. The way we target our marketing is sending the right message to the right people. We can do that through segments. So a segment, for all intents and purposes in Mailchimp, is just a search of our existing data. Whether that are that data are tags and or in a field and or automatically generated or collected by Mailchimp. So let me show you an example. So let's do this. Let's create a segment with a tag of, and I've got a tag here you can see of international travel. So let me create a segment of international travel and where the person's email address contains .com.au. So all people in Australia, for example, that like international travel. I would just click new segment. I'll just make sure you can actually see and that I'm not in the way on the screen. So what we said is we wanted, and let's just do the email address first. So we wanted the email address, and I'll just scroll down here and you can look at this in your own time. I'll scroll down, click email address, and let's just go ends with .com.au, Australian email address, for example. And my other condition was click add where the tag is where the tags is where they tagged, and I said international travel. I'll click preview segment. And these are all the people, okay, my data is not that great, but these are all the people that match the condition of containing international travel tag and ending with .com.au. Then I would save the segment. I won't do it right now, but I'll save the segment. Then, actually, let me do it to show it, sorry. I'll click save segment and let's just call this, I'll just call it segment one. You can call it anything. You would make it more meaningful than I'm saying, okay? Make it something that makes sense. Click save and I'll just demonstrate quickly. I'll just very quickly refresh my audience. And if I now click view segment, we'll look for that one called segment one. There it is. And at any time I can then click that. Also, when we're creating our email campaign, we can send to a segment, or just we can create a segment on the fly or a tag. But a segment is a search of, essentially, of our data. Now, segments are calculated at the time of sending. So for example, if we create our segment today and then we send in a week's time, if people meet those conditions that we add in the next week, they will be sent the email. So they're dynamic in that nature. So just to summarize again, tags is just data that we add. A segment is a search of our existing data. Very last question for today. How do I add the recipient's first name to an email? Okay, that's really important. Personalization in marketing, hugely important. We know from tons of data, tons of research, that when we personalize our emails, we get better results. And even just adding the first name, for example. And it's incredibly simple in Mailchimp, actually. So let me go and start creating a new campaign to illustrate how we add the first name to an email. Let me just click the little create button, click email, and we can call this anything. I'll just call it test. I'll click begin. So I'm creating an email at the moment. I'm going to click add recipients, add the audience first of all. You must add an audience, by the way, before you create the merge tag. You can have issues if you don't, and you often won't see the merge tag, what I'm about to show, if you don't select your audience first, because often people say to me, why aren't merge tags appearing when they go to add the merge tag? And the answer is because they haven't selected the audience first. You must select your audience first. Right. So let's go to design email and I'll show how we add each individual recipient's first name into the email dynamically. Wherever we have a text block, so this is the new email builder in Mailchimp, but you can do it in the old one too. Wherever we have a text block, I'll click on it. And let me just add some text saying, for example, let's just do this. Let's just add it on the end. Okay. So all we do to add the first name for each recipient is we click merge tags and look for the first name. But you can include any data that's in your audience, but here it's first name. Okay. So the first name of each individual recipient will automatically be inserted by Mailchimp. But we can do it wherever. So we could even do it here. Let's just add it at the beginning. Merge tags. First name. Okay, so first name, and let's just go, it's time to design your email. Okay, so that's how we do it, and then we can send it. But I just need to show one more thing, although that wasn't a question from today, but what I'm often asked is, what happens if you don't have the first name of a recipient? What would show when we're using the first name merge tag? Well, by default in Mailchimp, it'll be empty. But I'll show you how you can add a default, such as customer. So if you don't have a person's first name, customer will appear, for example. So let's just, let's finish this. Let's just, I'm gonna click on Freddy, the mascot to the top left. Let me just go into my audience. I'm gonna click the down arrow next to manage audience. And actually, let me show another way of doing it. I'm gonna rather click on my number of contacts to see my entire audience. So what I'm wanting to do is set a default merge tag value, set a default first name that will appear if I'm using the first name merge tag in an email and I don't have the person's first name. So all I do here is under settings, I click settings, I click audience fields and merge tags. On the left-hand side, you can see my field labels and type. So there's the first name. And if I go to the extreme right, you will see that's empty. The value's empty. And that's why if I don't have the person's first name, it'll just be empty. But I can add here, for example, customer. And then if I click save to the bottom of the screen, where are we? Save changes. There we go. So now, if I use the merge tag, and I don't have the person's first name in the first name field in MailChimp, the word customer will appear. Thanks for joining me. My name's Gary from organicweb.com.au, and please subscribe to my channel. Leave your questions below this email if you'd like them answered, but thank you very much for joining me.